Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are ready for the second match of the evening here. Day one, of course, of the CIB PSA World Tour Finals 2022. And as I said, we're going to switch our attention now to the men's half of the draw. England versus Egypt in this next match. And we'll start with a player who's playing in his highest world ranking to date, a place of world number 8. He represents Egypt, his 290th appearance on the PSA World Tour with 7 PSA World titles, a semi-finalist at the Tournament of Champions and the British Open and the Canary Wharf Classic in his season during 2022. So let's hear it for the Black Falcon, Mazen Hesha! And his opponent this evening is a former world number 1, the current world number 3, and making his 623rd appearance on the PSA World Tour. 44 PSA titles now, and he was the runner-up most recently at the Mauritius Open just last week, the Manchester Open also this year, and of course the World Championships in 2022. From England, it is the world number 3, the beast, Mohamed El Shabagi! Let's give you a bit of history between these two then. 6 love in Mohamed El Shabagi's favour as far as those head-to-heads go. So they met 6 times on the PSA World Tour. Last week, all the way back in March 2018.
Welcome back to the first men's match of this competition. Mohamed El Shabagi of England, the number 5 seed, taking on the number 8 seed from Egypt, Mazen Hesham. Him in the commentary box for this first men's match, Lee Drew.
Hey, Joey.
Well, the sun has certainly now dropped behind the pyramids as we're taking off for this CIB PSA World Tour Finals in New Giza. Good to see a busy, pretty busy first night already, Lee.
Yeah, it's got a good vibe going on down there by the court. Quite a few people milling around, a few players there as well. Saw the Terminator, Noran Gohart, an interested spectator at the side of the court on that last one. Got a bit of work to do here, I think, Mazen Hesham. It's number 8 seed coming into this, currently ranked its highest ranking, 8 in the world. Of course, he had that great British Open where he got to the semi-finals. And that's sort of the real pinnacle of his season so far in terms of form. But he's a player that wants to establish himself amongst these top 8 players, the top 8 seeds in the world. Going to have to really nail his consistency to establish himself in this top 8. I think someone that's not lacking consistency, Joey, is the man in our picture now. He's really stepped it up.
Yeah, Michael Absalom, he has certainly stepped it up.
He's looking very cool and linen-y, Michael Absalom.
Well, Mohamed El Shabagi just winning the British Nationals after making the announcement of now representing England during the Mauritius Open. Losing in the final to Diego Elias there, getting valuable points though. And then heading to Manchester to take out James Waltrop and Joel Makin to win his first national title in England. Got a good respectful ovation from the local crowd here in Cairo.
Yeah, I wonder if he'd have been slightly nervous to see what the response would be like, but it was certainly positive. you said, he's got a load of matches under his belt as well. But we know the Egyptian players have been busy as well, because there's been Egyptian League and they've all been playing each other. It's like they've had a prequel to this tournament. So it's not looking good for Hesham when you look at the heads-to-heads. 6-love in favour of El Shabagi.
Yeah, he's managed to qualify. It was all on the last event in Mauritius. It was between himself and Mohammed's brother, Marwan. Marwan El Shabagi losing out to Omar Mossad, which enabled Mazen Hesham to then qualify for this event. To say his first World Tour Finals, the Black Falcon.
Time.
Tamer Al-Nagari is the main referee for this. He's flown all the way over from America. There he is.
He did that last time, didn't he? 2 years ago as well, and it didn't work out well for him that trip.
No, he didn't. He got COVID within 3 hours of getting to Cairo. But he's good now. Just to reiterate to the viewers, the referees can't hear what we're saying. We're not talking to them directly, which some people have mentioned in the last period, which is one of the most bizarre things ever. So the timing of us saying something and a ref possibly smiling is just coincidence.
They probably know that you're going to be funny.
Play will start in 30 seconds.
Well, Mazen Hesham might feel the wrath of Mohammed El Shabagi here if he was the player that's taken the response to the place of his brother, a former winner at this event.
15 seconds.
Yeah, you know, with this event particularly, it is really important to get off to a good start in the group stages psychologically. Big advantage to get that first win in. Mohammed El Shabagi, the number 5 seed CID from England, PSA taking on Mazen Hesham, the number 8 seed from Egypt.
Men's round 1 match, Mohammed Shorbagi of England to serve, Mazen Hesham of Egypt to receive. Best of 3 games. Love all.
And we're in. Sure, we'll see plenty of short work here from Mazen Hesham. He is up for this mentally. It'd be very, very difficult in the best of 3 format for Black Falcon.
Yeah, I was just wondering what Black Falcon we would see. Are we going to see the patient building but trying to play at pace? Or are we going to see someone that's going to be a bit inconsistent and sort of take it in without necessarily constructing? Immediately, you can see how sharp El Shabagi is looking, moving into those front corners. Won't have had much time at all. He'd have probably flown on Sunday to get here to have that day off yesterday.
Too low.
Of course, the final of the British Nationals was only Saturday.
Mohammed El Shabagi really finding his dancing rhythm here.
3 love.
Very, very smooth.
I'm feeling very, very relaxed and flowing as well, Joey.
For love.
Well, it's unravelling a little bit here for Hesham.
Six love.
Got a bit of a mission here, Joey.
Yeah, he is. Last year as well, Mohamed El Shabagi getting absolutely chopped across the eye by Mustafa Assal. Ended up having his whole head taped up. Had to take it all off again, had no eyebrows left. He played on with it.
That could be cheap cosmetic work, Joey.
What do you mean?
What, the waxing?
Oh, the eyebrow waxing. Yeah. It's popular to get your eyebrows tattooed, Lee. You should look into it.
Down. And out 7-1.
Well, he's not feeling this, is he, Hesham?
No, he's not. And he can't serve quick enough.
Down.
I mean, he's hit so many errors already.
9-1.
In this first game.
Down. And out 2-9.
Oh, he's drilled him. He's walloped him right in the bump, back.
You okay? Yes, let.
Yeah, it's a let ball. Very courteous of Mohamed, 9-2 up. A bit different if it was match ball, but so we see it here. No, we don't. That was a massive stitch up. And then we see that, but we don't. It's a stitch. It's good to know everyone's on it.
Down.
Another error.
Hand out.
I mean, it's pretty much impossible, but we're almost into double figures of errors.
Mohamed's making Mazen get rid of the massive. What was that?
Takata.
Was it?
Yeah.
Good bit. 8 gay balls here for Shabagi, a man from the West Country.
Adam.
Very good call there. Players would have cracked on.
Hand out. 3-10 game ball.
It's always reassuring. A lot of game balls here for El Shabagi.
4-10 game ball.
Thank you.
Oh, dear.
This is
painful.
Yeah, it is. Oh, he's got it. Yeah, there we go. And there's the fist pump. There's a fist pump from Shibagi.
11-4 game to Shibagi.
Taking that first game. He's seriously up for this. There's an Hisham looking pretty despondent out there. Nine minutes. Shibagi strikes first, leading one game to love in round one.
Well, it's the perfect start for Mohamed El-Shibagi. Came out firing, he was looking sharp, but not quite the same for Mezen Hesham. Right from the off, he hit too many errors, just rattling them off, and you just can't afford at this level to give your opponent that many chances and opportunities and free points. So looking very solid for Mohamed El-Shibagi. He's keeping his form going that he showed last week at the British Nationals. So there we see the pools, how they line up. Got the game already in favour of El-Shibagi in pool or group A. Ali Farag, Diego Elias, I mean, those are seriously loaded. Look at that group B. Paul Cole, Asal, Tarek Momen, Joel Makin. Some serious matches ahead in this, Joey.
Yeah, good mix of nationalities there. Peru, England, New Zealand and Wales. Four Egyptians. As I say, it's a terrific formula that works very well specifically for this event.
Shibagi leads one game to love. Love all.
So a steadier start immediately from Mezen Hesham in this first game. See immediately how quickly El-Shibagi is onto the ball that's short. He's looking very sharp and he's clearly feeling very confident.
Yeah, nice steady play there from Shibagi. He's biding his time, staying patient.
One love.
Footing looks good for these players on the floor.
Looks like a very true bounce as well.
It is. It is a true bounce, but it does quite slightly stop the ball on the bounce, if you know what I mean. It doesn't fly through on it, skid through as
much. Yeah, it sits up, doesn't it?
Yeah, because there's, like I say, I will do it behind the scenes and really get on the floor. Lie on the floor with the camera at eye level, turn it into like a very intense kind of documentary about the bevels of like a wildlife program. You see where I'm coming from?
Yeah, definitely.
Quite like that. Oh,
stroke to his
yeah. If he didn't get a stroke there, he'd have been very annoyed because he really did want to make that there. We see the excitement. Look at that. Racket right behind the head.
Nowhere near the ball.
No, but right behind the head. The main thing.
And out 3-1. Nolet. And out 2-3. Please be seated.
Nice drop shot from Hesham. Running that ball in nice and tight. See, it gets the floor and then runs into the sidewall.
And out 4-3. Stroke to Hesham. Yeah, you didn't clear quickly. You were still in his way. You were still in his way. And out 4-all.
Well, the Black Falcon making a bit more of a fight here in this early stage of the second game. Nice play, good tight work, low error percentage,
five,
no risk,
four.
Effective stuff from him.
I feel like that's an area that you want to get the ball into against Shabagi as well. Test out his forehand when the ball is close to the sidewall.
Well, that's a bit special. That really is a bit special. Acknowledge there from Shabagi. This is a nice bit of flow. It's giving you a taste of what he can do, the world number eight, Mezen Hesham.
Out. Yeah, it touched the line. The ball touched the line.
It's very animated reaction from Mohamed El-Shabagi. He's absolutely convinced that it was under the line. He's got to keep calm, though, because he's been playing really well and he's under a bit of pressure here. Well, this time it's an error from Shabagi, so Hesham's really making a move here, and he's kept the ball out the tin.
Well, there we go. When you say he's making a move, it's not rocket science. Made close to eight errors in the first game, Mezen Hesham. gifting that to Mohammed El Shabagi.
And out 5-8. Down.
Well, unfortunately,
6-8.
The errors crept back in. Can he hold him off? Can he hold the beast off in his second get? Oh, it's a great shot.
He's going for the kill, isn't he? He's got himself within striking distance, and he's really going for this. That's a lovely shot.
Yeah, very nice finish. There's the clench of the fist.
How much cut does he put on this backhand drop shot?
7-8.
It's what allows him to have that full swing.
You add that cut and also the glass floor, you get a very, very high quality short ball that dies away, doesn't come back at all. Oh, my word.
He's got it.
Yeah, it's well played.
Straight to Hisham.
He earned that brilliantly. That was a terrific shot from Mezen Hisham. And then just behind Shabagi.
Nine,
it was good effort getting this back, to be fair, to Shabagi. It was good movement. Just couldn't quite clear. Getting exciting now. Starting to hot up here in Cairo.
Definitely changes the dynamic of the game, the way the ball sits up. Got to adjust your shot, the way you strike it, especially into those back corners to get the ball dying away and moving away from the opponent. I'm going to be interested to see how players like Ali Farag, who is a player who loves to have the ball dying and running away, adapts to this.
Hold that. Hand out 8-9.
Well, the leaping El Shabagi playing that volley drop into the front, taking it too early for Hisham.
9-all.
Well, Mohammed El Shabagi will certainly want to close this out in two games. Just don't know what you're going to get with the Black Falcon. Good work.
Video referee decision. Oh, he went for it.
There's a review.
Shorbagi on the stroke.
He was ready very quickly here, Hisham.
He read it. He read this, the Black Falcon. There.
He was like a superhero with his reactions there.
Yeah, the wings were up.
Look, he's onto that so quickly, and the ball is so close to El Shabagi. I think this is going to stay as a stroke, mate.
Well, I agree. I mean, it's clear as crystal.
Stroke to Hisham, decision upheld. Shorbagi has no reviews remaining. Hand out, 10-9, game ball.
Wonderful pronunciation from Sam El Nagari.
So, terrific photo of him on his pass there. Cross between Poirot and Suge Knight.
Down. Physio, please, for Mr. Hisham.
So, the physio's been asked.
11-9, game to Hisham, one
taken
game
all. The second game, Mohammed just looking at Mezen Hisham, trying to work out why the physio was asked. But he's wants it, probably those shins of his on the glass floor. Derek Ryan will be there very quickly. He'll have his rubber gloves on. ready to work on those shins, I'd imagine. But it's one game all in this first men's match, 24 minutes played, best of three format.
Well, it's much better from Mezen Hisham there. He was a lot more consistent. He extended the rallies a little bit more. Not half as many errors in that game, and he had to keep the ball out of the tin to stay in it.
Yeah, like you say, it's really not rocket science at any level, particularly at this level. You're playing one of the best players in the world who's getting back into form. You start giving 3 points away, you're going to be up against it. Knuckle down, there's some nice smiling fans. The wind is certainly picking up. You can see it through the crowd and the towel there of Mezen Hisham. Still yet to see. It's Derek Ryan down on his knees there. Yeah, he is. That was quite slick of Derek Ryan. We couldn't quite see it, but it definitely was a bit of the... He likes to have a bit of the anti-inflammatory or the kind of pain-numbing cream on his shins. Anyway, serving, let's see. He will be able to maintain that level of squash that took him to win the second game.
15 seconds. One game all, Hisham to serve, Lovell.
Which Hisham we're going to get in this game. I have to say, it was nicely picked off by El Shabagi. It was a real setup.
One love.
And then the cross court played onto the forehand volley of El Shabagi. Tough rally, a clever shot down the middle of the court.
Two love.
Hisham's about as skillful as you get, and he couldn't deal with this. See that? Such a clever shot at the body. Players coming up behind, looking to close down the court, looking for the volley, generally looking for the cross court. It's good work from Shabagi. The fact that he's not fazed by losing that game, of course it's high-risk stuff when someone levels at one game all. The fact that it's now the winner takes all in this game changes the dynamic, doesn't it?
One of your favourite songs by ABBA.
One of them. The favourite.
Handout 1-2.
Getting that ball so tight again, Hisham.
I'll tell you, I'm going to really enjoy doing a piece on this glass floor because it just reminds me of my cricketing days. Because of the grip of the glass, if you topspin the ball or cut it, you can see it deviate even more than on a wooden floor.
So if you were thinking about cricket, it's the equivalent of having a spinner's wicket, really.
Excited about doing that. That is not a great shot at all.
I can't wait to see you lying on your tummy, 3-2. Examining it.
I will. Do a real proper job on it. Yeah, get a piece of it in my mouth to see if I could snap it. 1-3-all. Nothing between them at the moment in the early stages of this crucial and final
3-all.
Third game.
That is lovely touch from Hesham.
Well, I'm pleased that the Black Falcon has arrived at the party, not flown straight through the building and out the other end.
Hand out 4-3.
Just don't know what you're going to get with Hesham. It's exquisite at times.
Yeah, he's when he's getting it right, it's like a box of Belgian chocolates.
Must be so hard to play against. You just got to accept it, haven't you? The fact that you're going to get some cheap points and then you're going to be on the end of some outrageous winners.
Well, to be fair, what you're seeing here is why he's managed to get to his highest world ranking of number 8 in the world. The consistency of the hitting. Quality of work to the back of the court, which then opened, oh my word, the leisure centre boast going right in the bottom of the tin there. And it certainly had Mezin Hesham perceived split step went.
Out for all.
Thinking it was going to be a cross court. 30 minutes.
Well, it's tough work here. Hesham doing really well to reset this rally. Trouble. He was looking to defend, but problem is when you lose your racket over the ball, when you're trying to defend, the odds are you're going to drag it down rather than actually get it spinning up and over. Farag is about the only person I know that can lob like that on the forehand.
Quickly, please. Quickly.
Having to work hard here, El Shabagi. Just eked that 1-point lead in this third.
Down. 6-4. And out 5-6. Thank you.
crucial rally, this. It's a huge point. See what amazes me, Joey, how far up the court they step to close the court down. Look how far El Shabagi's pinning himself up, looking for the volley.
Yeah, it's brilliant. It's a terrific rally.
Oh, what a shot.
Wonderful rally there. Shabagi really feeling it, but just
and
showing
7-5.
How he deals when he is feeling confident with the physical side of things. Just pushes, steps up. When it starts to burn in the quads, starts to feel the fatigue, he still goes up again. He doesn't back off. He never has.
I mean, anyone.
I say he never has. When I mean, when he's in the condition mentally where he knows that he's into a decent bit of form. You know, I'm taking away the months.
Not that.
Hesham's moved to the player there, not the ball. Watch this. First movement straight to Shabagi.
Eight,
rather than
five.
Going to where that ball is bouncing.
All credit to Mohamed El Shabagi. He's managed to conjure up a three-point lead in this third game. So we hit the back end, the business end.
That is a crucial error. The resistance is going here from Hesham.
Match ball.
Yeah, five match balls. The beast is back on the M5.
It's absolutely volleying everything. That's how good El Shabagi feels on the court right now.
I don't know if he feels that good, actually. He's just closing it down and just making it. Honestly, I see him dropping
11,
off.
5, match
five ball,
Shabagi,
and he just went up into
one.
An extra gear.
11-4.
Look at him,
9,
there.
11,
he's tired. He's feeling the effects there of the heat and also the scheduling. I tell you, it'd be interesting if Michael asked him about that, because at 5-all, he stepped up when he could have dropped off quite easily with the fatigue that was going through his body. So Mohamed El Shabagi holding off the Black Falcon that did arrive in the second game and halfway through the third. We're going to hear from him now with Michael.
Mohamed, congratulations. Well done. What a way to start off your campaign here at the World Tour Finals. Always nice to get that first win under the belt. How did it feel for you? How's the court playing?
I really like the glass floor. I think that's the first test today was, and I think it's great for the sport that we're trying something different, something that I think it will clearly work, and I think can be used in technology in our sport. It's definitely a step forward. I'm a big supporter of it, and yeah, I can't wait to get them back on that floor again in 2 days.
One thing that was noticeable was the cut. When you were putting the cut on the ball, we could really sort of see the difference that made on the court and how short that left the ball and made it a struggle for your opponent.
Yeah, it's a court that is, of course, it's different. You have to adapt to it differently. I think every point we're playing better. I knew after a lot of the second game I was in big trouble, so I had to try and find something different, which I fought, to be fair, and at 5-4 we had that big rally, and I was lucky enough to win that rally, and I'm really glad that I won it, and yeah, I really can't wait to go back and play here again.
And a lovely warm reception when you came in as well, now playing in your home from home, of course, representing England, but back here in Egypt. And that must have been a nice feeling to get such a nice warm welcome back here in Egypt.
I'll just say that in Arabic. أود أشكر كل الناس اللي جت شجعني النهاردة. انتوا مش عارفين بجد يمكن النهارده كان من النهارده بالذات كان يوم من اهم ايام حياتي ان انتوا تيجوا النهارده تشجعوني انتوا مش فاهمين انا اليوم ده هفتكره لغايه طول حياتي شكرا لكم جدا شكرا لكم جدا وان شاء الله ارجع العب قدامكم ان شاء الله لسنين قدام وان شاء الله افضل احاول اكسب بطولات قدامكم شكرا لكم جدا شكرا
Listen, thanks very much. Well done. We'll see you in a couple of days' time. Ladies and gentlemen, Mohamed El Shabagi.
Oh,
Well, there we go. That's a decent reception there for Mohammed El Shabagi.
Yeah, El Shabagi made to work for this game. Mazen Hisham really pushing right the way until 5-all. But then we saw El Shabagi stepping up the court. He closed the court down. He pinned himself on that short line and from there was able to volley the ball and really take the game to Hisham. And it was that move that was able to close the match out for El Shabagi.
Some very, very good squash, particularly in that second and mid-stage of the third game. Mohammed El Shabagi then pushing on to take it 2-1 to get his first win here at the CIB PSA World Tour Finals. Two matches down, four to go. And the third match coming up for you this evening, Joel King of New Zealand taking on Gina Kennedy of England, the number 8 seed. They'll be up in a couple of minutes. I'll be handing over to Lisa Aitken and Lee.